Hey guys, how's it going? This is David Kwan. Now, on all my videos about E3 2013, so far I've talked about Sony, I talked about Nintendo, so it's really now time to start talking about Microsoft and the future of Xbox One. It's a particularly tricky one, I think. Trying to wrap my head around what the future of Xbox One might be like after seeing all the stuff that happened on E3 2013. What is the future for Xbox One? And will it do well? Will it not do well based on the gamer reaction, based on the consumer reaction? It's a tough one. I'm trying to wrap my head around it, and I don't have an easy answer for it, but I do have an example here. And this example actually totally shocked me watching this happen. But Tara Long is a gaming journalist for Red3 website, and she talked about how she interviewed a developer behind Contrast, and Contrast is a downloadable game. So she asked the developer, like, so what platform is this game going to come out on? And the developer was like, it's going to come out on PS3, Xbox 360, and PlayStation 4. Tara was just like, okay, what about Xbox One? The developer answered, we're independent. That was the answer. So, wow, I was totally shocked by that, actually. I did not expect that kind of answer from a game developer. So this game developer is making a game for PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 4, okay? But it's also making a game for Xbox, it's making this available, the same game available for Xbox 360 through Xbox Live Arcade Network. Okay? So they're not totally against Microsoft. They're willing to put their game on the 360. But then they're like, we're independent. We're not putting our game on Xbox One. So something about Xbox One really irks them. The principle of Xbox One, they're totally against it to the point they're not going to release their game on the Xbox One, despite the fact that they're probably going to make a killing. They're probably going to make a lot of profit by releasing the game on the Xbox One as well. That's crazy. I think that's going to set an interesting precedent. But I don't know if precedent is the right word to use, because I don't think many developers will follow suit. I think many developers will be comfortable with the idea of making games for Xbox One, honestly. But this is an interesting circumstance where a developer will not develop a game for that console simply because they don't think the principle behind that console is independent, is right. Because as an independent, if you're an independent developer, what that kind of suggests, what that implies is that you do what you want to do with your game. You make your game however you want to make it, and it's independent. You're not constrained by the demands of a publisher just screaming down at you and being like, you have to make the game this way, or else. I think some aspect of that is still existent and prevalent with independent games, no matter what kind of independent game it is. That game company had an exclusive contract with Sony to make 3 exclusive games for Sony. So there is kind of just because you're an independent developer doesn't mean you have total freedom. It might be the total opposite of that, because you don't have the resources necessary to be as free as you want. For example, like Blizzard has total freedom in what they want to do with how they want to make their game because they have all the resources in the world to do so, and they're not independent. But I don't know, for an independent developer to say something like that, it was totally shocking to me. So it really just does make an interesting point about what the future of Xbox One might be like if the consumer reaction to Xbox One is so negative. And what's worrisome to me is that the message that Microsoft is going to send about Xbox One is not going to be clear to the consumers. To me, I'm a hardcore gamer. I already know about Xbox One. I know I'll never purchase it. And I might not even accept it free other than to sell it, right? Simply because of the whole Kinect thing. But that's me. I know my stuff about the gaming industry. But what about people who don't know, right? And people just go and buy Xbox One and they realize, oh my gosh, the internet went out, we were moving. They lived in this house for a good amount of years, but they are moving to a new place. And in that new place, they're not going to have internet access for the first 2 months of moving there. Well, guess what? They're not going to be able to play Xbox One. Now, what worries me is Microsoft is not going to send a clear message to its consumers, to its potential customers, that Xbox One can't be utilized without internet connection, without daily checkup, daily connection to the internet connection. For most customers, this is not going to be a problem. You know, most people who buy the Xbox One, this is not going to be a problem at all. I'm connected to the internet almost every single day for 24 hours a day, 24/7. So it's not going to be a problem. And the used games thing, if you always buy your games new, totally not a problem. You can, Microsoft still does let you trade in used games with participating retailers. So you can't eBay your game. But there's still some leeways here and there that Microsoft allows you to do. So it's not totally draconian. There's still some things that Microsoft supports. Being able to play all the games that you own without having to switch discs. And being able to share that game collection instantly with your family members. Again, I mean, these are pretty cool concept that Xbox One offers that PS4 you can't do that with. So there is an advantage with Xbox One, but how much that advantage, is that something that is going to win over customers, consumers? Or is that something that's going to enrage customers once they realize this is how things work on Xbox One? The reaction from the public is going to be an interesting one, from the mainstream public that end up buying Xbox One. Now, the biggest question about the future of Xbox One to me is Michael Pachter's prediction about it, about Microsoft. And I kind of agree with him. There's no way that Xbox One is just retailed at $499 and that's it. I don't see that. I think Michael Pachter makes really good sense in talking about how Microsoft is planning to release Xbox One with a subscription-based pricing structure. And this subscription-based pricing structure is going to be partnered with cable networks and cable companies. So Cablevision is a big company in New York City. Comcast or companies like that. They're going to be like, hey, do you want to, if you do a two-year contract with us and you sign this agreement saying that you are going to be exclusively signed on to our cable company for 2 years, then we will give you, we'll be able to sell you or give you a voucher for the Xbox One. And that voucher will be like $200 or $300, so you could buy an Xbox One at $200 or $300 or even just $100, right? There is this subscription-based contracting fee, a contract thing or pricing structure. I actually think Microsoft is going to try that. It would be dumb for Microsoft not to do so because this is a really expensive system. And when you have this kind of system and you have the PS4 and people are like, oh my gosh, I can buy Xbox One for $200 and PS4 costs $400. Now, Xbox One seems like it has much more stuff. The camera, the controller, the system itself, and whatever game it is bundled with, whatever, it seems like a really great deal. It's just that I would have to, stick with my cable company for 2 years. Okay, I'm on board. If Microsoft does this, Xbox One has a really good shot at being a huge seller, especially in America. I'm not sure about the other countries, actually. I'm not sure about Europe. And Japan, I think that's forget about it. You know, Asia, forget about it. That's not going to happen. Because there's no way Microsoft can get a contracting deal with an Asian cable company, a TV company. I don't think that's going to happen. But I think at least in America, or maybe even in the United Kingdom, Microsoft could make this happen. And I think they're trying to lay the groundwork for that. And if that does happen, I do feel like Xbox One will be very successful as long as there's no huge backlash over how consumers can't use it when they're not online. So that's kind of the thing to look for. Honestly, with the policies that Xbox One has, I have a bias against Xbox One. I really don't want it to succeed that much. I just don't like the policies that Xbox One has. So me personally, I think actually this is the one time and the only time I've actually felt that a console should fail. I really have not wished that on any console before. Every console that ever existed, even though I do not like the games on Xbox 360 or whatever, I don't like the fact that on you know, Xbox 360. I've never liked the fact that I had to pay online, and now I don't like the fact that I have to pay online to play online on the PlayStation 4. I don't like it. But that dislike was never big enough to the point where I'm just like, I wish this console fails and don't sell well. Never was that point. But with the Xbox One, I'm feeling that way. And I don't know if that's it. It's just, I don't want the future of Xbox One to go well. I really don't. But I think it will go well. And that's the troubling thing. And if it does go well, like, I do have to wonder, like, what the consumer reaction will be, what the public mainstream's reaction will be to this kind of console. If it does well, then it kind of gives Sony the opportunity to also move toward this route. And also makes, I don't think Nintendo will ever follow suit, but you never know. You never know. I think Nintendo is the one bastion of hope to keep things the way they are and not move towards this kind of future and try to force down, force digital distributed future down our throat and shoving it down our throat. Microsoft is certainly trying, and I hope it fails. I really do. So I have to wonder what the future of that is going to be like. But honestly, I think, at least in America, Xbox One will be a big success. And honestly, you know, I mean, as I know Xbox One is so, it feels so anti-consumer, but at the same time, I get why it can actually be a good thing for the gaming industry if it is successful. And this is, I don't really like talking this way in this topic, but it can be because it does prevent used games. It makes the gaming industry, it makes the developers get more money, they make more profit, so maybe it makes the entire industry more healthy overall because there's less piracy and there's less selling of used games and there's people buying just games new, or maybe it's like Steam and there's sales everywhere all the time on Xbox Live. I don't know what the future of Xbox One is going to be like. This is a really troubling thing to me. I can't wrap my head around it, honestly. There's so many questions to ask. The biggest problem I had with the whole Microsoft concept is this. And this is a telling sign. And I tweeted about this. But the biggest problem I had was at E3, whenever a console manufacturer attends E3, they take questions before E3. An interviewer like Jeff Keighley will interview Don Matrick or Phil Spencer or Phil Harrison. And they'll do it. They'll do the interview. They have the E3 conference. And there's a post-conference roundtable. Every company does this. You know, Reggie Fils IME will be interviewed after, you know, Nintendo does their press conference. Jack Tretton does an interview after the Sony conference. Microsoft this year, this E3 2013, they canceled their post-conference roundtable. They canceled it. They've never done that before in the history of E3, in the history of gaming conventions. Never happened before. But Microsoft suddenly decided to cancel its post-conference roundtable. To me, what I get from that is like, wow. Like, Microsoft doesn't want to talk to its consumers. Doesn't want to give a direct message about what it plans to do with its policies. It's backing out. It's copying out. And that's not a good sign to me. It's a horrible sign to me what the future of Microsoft's attitude will be towards its consumers. And I'm kind of terrified of what might happen with Xbox One.